Map reading. There's actually no difference between the reading of a map and a comprehension test. All of you guys have done comprehension tests. Now, what do you do when you do a comprehension test? First thing you've got to do is to read your test, your passage 2, 3, 4 times. Am I right? After you've read that, then you will have nearly kind of mental image or mental knowledge of what you have read. Then it's going to become easy to answer the questions. But what do you do in a map work exams? You do the opposite. You take the map, you read question one, and you try to look for the answer in the map. Now, if you should do that with a comprehension, you can imagine what's going to happen. You don't read the comprehension, you read the question and look for the answer. Question two, read the question, look for the answer. Now, exactly the same is going to happen to you if you don't spend at least 10 minutes reading the map. Now, how do you read a map? That's very important. Reading a comprehension is easy. You know the alphabet, you know words, you know punctuation. But how do we read a map? Let's have a look at this. The first thing you've got to know is that there are 5 things that you read a map. 5 very important things. The first thing is relief. You must look at the brown part of the map and see where's the brown. Ask yourself, where's the brown? Where's the high parts? Where are the low parts? Where's the valleys? Where are the hills? Secondly, the drainage. Where are the rivers? What type? Have you got a lot of dams there? What does the blue, what does it tell me of the climate of the area? We've got a lot of dams. It could be seasonal rainfall. It could be a lack of rainfall, very low rainfall. That's why we've got a lot of blue there. If you've got a lot of non-perennial streams, it means, well, I've not got enough rainfall there. Okay, drainage. The third thing that I have to look at is your infrastructure, which would be in red for your main roads and, of course, in black for your railway lines. Then your settlements. Very important, right? And then the last one would be your economic activities, mostly your farming activities found on your topo map. But what's very important is that these things don't stand as separate blocks. They are all related to each other. And did you know that a map work question paper, all that your teacher or the examiner is doing is testing you if you know the relationships between the things found on the map. That's very, very important. And if you know the relationships between all these things, all these colors that we've done now, then you are on your way of becoming a very successful map reader. Now, we call this, I just call this the R-DICE method. R for relief, D for drainage, I for infrastructure, S for settlement, and E for economic activities. So when you read your map, you use this R-D-I-S-E, and you see, you have a look, where do I find all these things? And after you've done that, you will have a mental image of the map. Now, let's have a look at an example. How do I apply this on a map? Now, I'm going to read Sirius to show you how can I get a better understanding of the map before I answer the question paper. The first thing I have to look at is the brown. And that's, if I see that this is the brown, people, then you know a lot of Sirius already. You know here's a mountain and there's a valley. And immediately you will know there will be certain things that I'll find in the valley that I won't find on the mountain. I will find my settlements. I will find the farming activities here in the valley and not in the brown area. Very important. Now you've got a mental image of what Sirius looks like according to its relief. Then the blue. Have a look at the blue here. Here we've got the river running here. We've got lots of dams. And if you look at the lots of dams here, the non-perennial streams that we've got here, it tells you definitely we've got seasonal rain in Sierras because of all the dams and all these things. Because if it was a rainfall throughout the year, it wouldn't have been like that. Then the red and let's just put the other one also as well. Here we've got the infrastructure, the main roads there. Here we've got the railway line. Very important. Now immediately you see, okay, here's the main roads going here. Here's the railway line. Here I've got my settlement. See, where's the settlement? Here where my main roads actually meet. Very important that you must be able to see that. You must see that this is my settlement area, the gray that we've got here. I don't find the gray close to the, on top of the brown because it needs a flat area. You see, they need water. That's the river, the relationship. Remember I said it's a geography has to do, a second question paper map book has to do with relationship. Relationship between the blue and the gray, between the brown and the gray that we've got here. And then, of course, we've got our farming activities or the economic activities here around Sears. Why do we find it there? Right, the flat area that we've got there. What is the relationship between the blue and the green and all those type of stuff? We don't find this green also on the mountain here. We also need in a valley, a flat place here. And of course, the industries that we've got there. The industries. Why have we got the industries here? Right? Here we've got the railway line. What's the relationship between the industries and the railway line? What's the relationship between the green, in other words, the farming activities and the industries that we've got here in Sears? Now, once you've done that, grade 11s, take your map and read that map. Use a quarter of an hour, to 10 to 15 minutes to read your map. You've got an hour enough. You've got over enough time. Read your map, and after you've done what I've done with any other map, look at your five colors. Ask yourself, where is it? What's the relationship between all these things? You know what's going to happen? You will be able to answer certain questions on your question paper without going back to the map, because you've read your map, just as you've done with your comprehension test, that you will find certain answers that you can answer without going back to your passage.